Hello everyone, I, Mrs. Vinita Philip, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering of AISSMS, Institute of Information Technology, Pune, welcome you all for my series of videos pertaining to important topics of the subject Artificial Intelligence for BE ENTC 2015 pattern. In this video, I would be discussing the breadth first search technique. There are basically two types of search techniques in AI. One is the uninformed search strategy and the other is informed search strategy. Uninformed search or blind search or brute force method are the different names for this search technique. The term means that the AI agents have no information about the number of steps or the path cost from the current state to the goal. All they can do is distinguish a goal state from a non-goal state. That is, search algorithm produces the search tree without using any domain knowledge, which is brute force in nature. In contradiction to this is the strategy that uses best choice consideration and are called informed search strategies or heuristic search. Uninformed search is less effective than informed search. There are six uninformed search strategies and they are breadth first search, uniform cost search, depth first search, depth limited search, iterative deepening search, bidirectional search. All these different uninformed search strategies are distinguished by the order in which nodes are expanded. Breadth first search uses first in first out and uses data structure queue. In this strategy, the root node is expanded first and then all the nodes generated by the root node are expanded next and then their successors and so on. In general, all the nodes at depth D in the search tree are expanded before the nodes at depth D plus 1. Breadth first search is a very systematic strategy because it considers all the paths of length 1 first, then all those of length 2 and so on. Let us take an example. For this given graph, first, when we insert A, the node A, and when we take out A from the queue, we get to now check the paths from A, which are B, C, D. Please note that in any order it can be written as C, B, D or D, C, B, but keep any one order constant to solve further. Now if we remove B from the queue and check the paths from B, which are E, F, so these elements need to be inserted from the tail and the exit is from the head. So writing the remaining elements after taking out B, which is CD, and inserting the new elements from the tail, we get CDEF. This is the rule of first in first out. Similarly, now when C is taken out from the queue, the path from C, which are GH, needs to be inserted from the tail, so we get DEFGH. When D is now taken out from the queue, the path from D, which is I, needs to be inserted from the tail, so we get EFGHI. When E is taken out from the queue, the path from E, which are JK, needs to be inserted from the tail and we get FGHIG.
When f is taken out from the queue, we see that f is leading to no new path. So we take out g from the queue, and the path from g, which is l, needs to be inserted from the tail, so we get hijkl. Similarly, now when h is taken out from the queue, we see that h is leading to no new path. So we now take out I from the queue, and the path from I, which is M, needs to be inserted from the tail. So we get JKLM. When K is taken out from the queue, the path from K, which is N, needs to be inserted from the tail. So we get LMN. When L is taken out from the queue, we see that L is leading to no new path. So we take out M from the queue, and we see that M is leading to no new path, and finally we reach our goal state, that is node N. We see that BFS proceeds with each shallowest node, that is level wise. BFS technique definitely reaches the goal state and hence is complete. If suppose the cost of each path is 1, then BFS leads to finding the solution with cheapest cost and shortest path. So it is optimal. The time and space complexity is given as order of b raised to d, where b is the branching factor and d is the depth of the solution. That's all for now. Stay tuned for many such videos on important topics of the subject artificial intelligence. Thank you for watching.